So students, this is first lecture of second chapter, that is energy resources. It is for 16 marks. Our course is environmental studies. Course code is 22447. Course outcome from this chapter is select alternative energy resources for engineering practice. Learning outcome or unit outcomes are list various natural resources. Describe renewable, non-renewable and cyclic resources. Content for whole the chapter is natural resources, forest, water, energy, land and mineral. Renewable, non-renewable and cyclic resources. These are the types of natural resources. Causes and effects of depletion of resources and solution for depletion. Then different types of energy forms, how to conserve energy, that is energy conservation methods, then overuse of natural resources and its impact on the environment. Natural resources are being utilized at very fast rate as never before. If consumption rate is higher than depletion starts, natural resources meet requirement of food, shelter and energy. There are three types of natural resources: renewable resources, non-renewable resources and cyclic resources. Now first type of natural resources is renewable energy resource. They are available for long time by nature. For example, solar or sun energy, wind energy, hydroelectric, geothermal, biofuel and tidal energy or power. Then second type of natural resources is non-renewable, that exist in limited supply. They face shortage or get extinguished at the point of time. For example, soil, forest, water, mineral, natural gas, petroleum, coal. These are the example of non-renewable resources. Third type of natural resources is cyclic resources, for example, water. Life on Earth uses water for consumption in various needs. There being 70% water converted on Earth due to solar energy, the surface of water evaporates, leads to cloud forming and again there in rainfall. Therefore, it is categorized as cyclic resource. Then first natural resource is forest resource. Forests are useful to maintain ecological balance. These are the important renewable resources. Forests vary in composition and diversity and can contribute substantially to the economic development of any country. Plants, along with trees, cover large areas, produce variety of product and provide food for living organisms and also important to save the environment. It is estimated that about 30% of world's area is covered by forest. Among all the continents, Africa has largest forested area, that is 33%. Then significance of forest, that is importance of forest. Forest can provide prosperity of human being and to the nation. Important uses of forest can be classified as commercial use, ecological use or significance, then aesthetic value, and last one is life and economy of tribal. What are the uses of forest? First use in detail, that is commercial value. Forests are main source of any commercial products such as wood, timber, pulpwood, etc. About 1.5 billion people depend upon the fuel wood as an energy source. Timber obtained from the forest can be used to make plywood, boards, doors and windows. It is also used in agricultural implements and sports goods. Timber is also a raw material for preparation of paper, rayon, and film. Forest can provide food, fiber, edible oil, and drugs. Forest lands are also used for agriculture and grazing. Forest is important source for development of dams, recreation, and mining. Then second significance of forest is life and economy of tribal. Forests provide food, medicine, and other products needed for tribal people and play vital or important role in the life and economy of tribes living in the forest. Ecological use of forest. Forests are habitat to all wild animals, plants, and support billions of species. They help in reducing global warming caused by greenhouse gases and produces oxygen upon photosynthesis. Forest can act as pollution purifier. Aesthetic value, that is beautiful appearance. All over the world, people appreciate the beauty of forest because forests have greatest aesthetic value. Then next is over-exploitation of forest. Forest contributes substantially to the national economy. With increasing population, increased demand of fuel wood, expansion of area under urban development and industries has led to over-exploitation of forest. Then what is deforestation? Deforestation, that is cutting of trees. Forests are burned or cut for clearing of land. Forests are destroyed to meet demand for wood, paper, and agricultural products. Deforestation is the clearing of natural forests by logging or burning of trees and plants in a forest area. Now, what are the causes of deforestation? Forest area in some developed areas has expanded. However, in developing countries, area under forest is showing declining trend, particularly in tropical region. Main causes are shifting cultivation, then commercial logging, then need for fuel wood, expansion of agribusiness, development project and growing need for food, raw material for industrial use. Now, what are the major effects of deforestation? Deforestation adversely and directly affect and damages the environment and living being. Major causes of deforestation are soil erosion and loss of soil fertility, decrease of rainfall due to effect of hydrological cycle. Main effects are expansion of desert, climate change and depletion of water table, loss of biodiversity, flora and fauna, environmental changes and disturbance in forest ecosystem. These are some two websites for the forest resources reference or natural resources or energy resources. Thank you.